Once there was a girl who went to take some bread and milk to her granny. In the woods, she met a wolf. He asked her where she was going. To my granny's house, she said. So he asked her what path she would take, the path of needles or the path of pins. The path of needles, she said. So he took the path of pins. He put her blood in a bottle and some of her flesh in a bowl on the table. Then the little girl arrived. Good day, Granny. I've brought you a loaf of bread and a bottle of milk. Thank you, my child, said the wolf. Help yourself to some of the meat and wine on the table. Then the little cat said, "A slut is she who eats the flesh of her granny." After she ate, the wolf said, "Undress yourself, my child, and come lie down beside me." "Where should I put my apron?" asked the girl. "Throw it in the fire. You won't be needing it anymore." And each time she asked where she should put her dress, her long stockings, her petticoat, her bloomers, the wolf said, "Throw them in the fire, my child. You won't need them anymore." When she crawled into bed, she said, "Granny, how hairy you are." "The better to stay warm, my child." "Granny, what big shoulders you have." "The better to carry the firewood with, my child." "Granny, what long nails you have." "The better to scratch with, my child." "Oh, Granny, what a big mouth you have." "The better to eat you with, my child." "Oh, Granny, I've got to go make pee-pee." "Make pee-pee here, my child." "But I've got to make caca, too." "Make caca here." "No, Granny, it will smell bad. Let me go outside." "Fine, fine," said the wolf. "But make it quick." So he attached a woolen rope to her ankle and let her go. He waited and waited. Finally, he became impatient and yelled, "Are you pinching off a big loaf out there? Are you dropping a big load?" She had undone the knot with a needle and tied the rope to a plum tree. He ran after her, but arrived at her house just at the moment she closed the door.